Have you ever thought that you could think yourself thin? According to Miraval coach Nordine Sahag, a big part of reaching a healthy weight is all about your mindset. I found out about this new approach outlined in his book, Mind Over Body. Okay, so let's talk about this book, and it says on the cover that it's a mind-body book. What exactly does that mean?
Well, I'm going to start, Jenny, with a saying that says, your thoughts become beliefs. Your beliefs becomes actions. Your actions becomes your destiny. Okay. I have been in the fitness field for 2.5 decades. Around the world, working with over 200,000 clients. The interesting pattern that came over and over and over was that clients, when they came to see me for the first time, they had a false belief, which was either that they were overweight or out of shape. That was the truth.
Like the woman in your book that kept saying it over and over and over.
That was the truth.
I'm overweight.
But it's not necessary for you to believe that is the truth, because if you do so, you will order your body to stay the same way, you see. So the reason why I wrote Mind Over Body is to help readers reframe that process of thinking and think well, rather than only eat and exercise well. Those are very important factors, very important keys to fitness, but they're only a little portion.
So how long does it take to reframe your mind that way?
You can reframe your mind and become, have your behavior become automatic in 21 days, if you wish to.
21 days.
21 days. But you have to do it. You have to go through the whole process, from the knowing to the doing. That middle part that is missing is in the book, Mind Over Body.
The rest of our interview is going to air at 6:25.
Interesting stuff, you know, positive affirmation. I think there's no doubt that works.
Just like a lot of other things, and as you know, I've worked in the fitness industry for many years, and I thought the most beneficial thing in there was telling people what to look for in a trainer so they're not wasting their money.
Right.
You know, there is a lot of fraud in that industry,
right.
So it had kind of some good advice on that, too.
Right.
So we'll have
yeah.
more coming up.
Talk to him about that in our next hour.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Yeah, positive affirmation.
Jeannie, thank you. And for Mark Bateman this morning, and new for you this morning, a local professional fitness coach says the key to lasting weight loss is all in your head. Well, I sat down to pick Nordine Sahag's head. We had the first part of this interview in our first hour. Here's the second part about his new book, Mind Over Body. And in the book, you lay out a pretty specific schedule where it's, you know, get up and I think do some mind exercises, then do your physical exercise, and then go to work and shower and eat. And do you have to follow that regimented
Absolutely.
Schedule?
Absolutely. But Jenny, if you think about it, most people, a lot of people, take more time smoking cigarettes, which just takes 5 to 10 minutes for one cigarette. It takes less time to go through your mental exercises and your physical exercises than smoking 10 cigarettes a day. That's in mind over body. Again, it's not about only doing, but about being. You're being fitness. You're not just doing fitness, which to me is the whole missing part. One has to be fitness in order to see results, not only see results, but become the result they wish to have forever.
Okay, so not everyone can afford to go to Miraval to come see you. Are these things that some people can learn in the book and do on their own?
Oh, absolutely. My experience at Miraval was a great experience, a phenomenal experience in which I managed to take and put it as a package, you know, for my clients that can't come to Miraval. And that's what I outlined in the book Mind Over Body.
Okay.
It's as simple as 24 minutes exercise and as simple as less than 20 minutes mind exercises.
So tell us about those clients. Have you had any Oprah sightings or trainings or
anything
like
that? Well, you know, I'm not going to mention any names, but, you know, in terms of Oprah, everyone knows that she loves Miraval. But I had tons of other celebrities and politicians. Believe me, they're wonderful people just like you and I. You know, to me, when I work with a celebrity, it's as, you know, as easy and as flowing as if I was working with you.
I knew you weren't going to give me the details, but I figured I'd try anyway for that. Okay, thank you so much. And we'll give everybody the details on the book signing.
Thank you,
as well.
Jenny. Thank you.
So, as promised, that book signing is tomorrow, Thursday, 7 p.m. at the Barnes & Noble. That's at 7235 North La Jolla here in Tucson. And then I also kind of got a little section from the book that I thought you all would find interesting. It's about matching beliefs with behavior. So, for example, you say, I eat a Milky Way bar just before getting on the treadmill, and my new belief is to lose weight. So your behavior is eating the Milky Way, and your new belief is that you want to lose weight. So they don't match, and his whole thing is matching up your behaviors with your beliefs, and he says it takes 21 days to do that.
To kind of get at the habit, right?
Right, to get the habit, exactly, okay. Exactly.
So he seems like such an intense, focused person just listening to him.
Extremely intense. Well, he's a former Mr. Universe and, you know, again, works at Miral, so he has quite a background and just extremely intense guy to interview, for
and,
sure.
Yeah, and I'm sure some of the people we've seen on television and such, he has worked with in mm-hmm. the past. He just can't tell us who they
I
are.
Not me. I wanted him to dish on that a little bit more, but next time.
626.